number 3 of 16 cassettes from The Waiting on God, August 22, 1984, Indianapolis Hilton.
Morning. So he gave this to me 3 hours and 15, 20 minutes ago. Look at all how this put together. How these fit in with the song 213. Now Radiance is going to sing number 13. And God knows all about what he's doing. Praise the Lord. You see how God works? He knows all about everything. It's just so great. If we can read it. See, if we can read. See, this didn't happen. See, I don't know anything. All I know, I'm nothing and I'm needy. And Jesus helped us. We want to give him all the glory, all the praise, all the honor. See, been striving through 50 years to be sure that God, Jesus, must have all the praise. He must have it all. Because we're only a little vessel, the least one he has. And God would reveal all these wonderful things. Put them all together. What, if God leaves the next session like this one, we're going to have to quit before long. And I'm not through near. I'm not near through. I'm not even started yet in the message unless the Lord will let me. But you see, if he leaves the next session like he leaves this one. Oh, Jesus, Heavenly Father, we'll praise, adore, and glorify you. Only thee could ever do it again. Only thee could ever do this again. Just like in Louisville, just like in Maranatha, just like in Scott Depot, just like in Sarasota, just like out in Salt Lake City, just like in Louisville, just like here in St. Louis. We just left there 3 days ago. Oh, Jesus, you did it all. Amen. Holy Spirit of God, you did it all. Oh, I prayed in the night. I've had 2 or 3 hours sleep all night. Crying and pleading, oh God, I need thee. You know what to do. I don't know what you want done.
No.
I don't know the program. I don't know what you want. These people have all come from various places, sacrificed to be with us, given their last mites, some of them. Don't know how they were going to make it sometimes, and God made a way. They all come in so we could work together and wait together to be taught how to lose our life, to find it again in Jesus. How to trust him with all of our heart and to lean not to our own understanding. See, he said that in the Old Testament. That's why all church leaders need to read that. Lean not to our own understanding. We can't make any plans. True. See, the Old Testament said he wanted to find a people that wouldn't lean to anything they knew. Anything they could figure out. That was in Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. And yet Jesus said the same thing. You see, why we've crowded out Jesus out of our churches is because we meant well, but we just planned it ourselves. Oh, we just get together and sing some songs, give some scripture, and preach a good sermon, and people said, well, it's nice. But he wanted to lead it. Look at all the people who would have got through some trials that week if he'd have led the service. Look how all the people have missed prison if he'd have led the service. Look at all the thousands and millions upon millions upon millions upon millions, a billion. It's a billion if God could have his way in the church. See, there's going to be a billion people lost because God couldn't have his way in the churches. See, it's not millions, it's a billion. Or billions. Do you know what he tells me? I'll let you figure it out. Because Jesus couldn't lead in the churches. See, he wants to, but we've got to die out. We've got to wait before him for years and wait and cry and die till he can reveal himself to us. What to do from morning to night. When I go into the pulpit, I don't know a bit more what to do than you do right this second. Well, if I did, I'd be doing it. It'd be my program. If I knew one thing. See, he wants to lead the service. He wants to lead every board meeting. He wants to lead every part of the services. All the churches. He knows where the pulpit's to be in the church. He knows what the hymn books are. He knows what the interior is to be. He knows the outside. He knows exactly everything. He wants to lead everything. Not some of them. Not most of them. Yes. Not most all. He says all. He wants to lead everything. Well, where did you get this revelation? I sure didn't get it in a book. I didn't get this one in a book either. I got it because God sent me into the world. My mother said when I was born, the Holy Ghost fell on her and me. Is that right, Terrence and Edward?
Yes, sir.
And Richard? See, I've got three of my own brothers here. Stand up, my three brothers, my own blood brothers. Is that, you knew that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. See, the Holy Ghost fell on me as I came from her body. She said, I bore five more sons. I did not have the witness of the Holy Spirit. And I said, Mother, this is serious. This is sacred. This is a grave responsibility. You may be seated. So God sent me into the world to tell the church and the laity that we can no longer lean on our own understanding, our own plans, our own ideas, our own setups in all situations of the churches. He wants to lead it completely and entirely. Here's my former pastor. He was our pastor for 13 years. I had such a great time with him and his wife and his children. And we talk about how Jesus wanted to lead the church back then, didn't we, brother? Yeah, he wanted to lead the church, wanted to guide the church, wanted to lead this and that one. Brother Bullis is here, and Brother Boggs is here right here. He's our pastor for 4 years. Remember how I used to cry out for the Lord to lead us? Yes. Well, it's so great. So wonderful. Have my pastors here with us. It was our pastors representing 17 years. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
My blood brothers, my children, my former pastors. Did we have a good time, Robert? By God's grace?
Yeah.
Wesley, did we have a good time?
Wonderful.
Because of Jesus?
Amen.
Now that means that God helped us.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I tell you what, I get excited about the fact that God helped us.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Healed, helped, and led in the parsonage with both families. I wish he was here so he could read it, some of the things that God has done with our dear ones and our churches, my home church where I was for 59 years. All right. Praise God. I'm a debt to Jesus for all he's done, all he's doing. Praise the Lord.
There's two more stanzas, but we don't
have let's have them. We don't want to miss those, honey. Oh, my. I was going to say, Radiance, I want you to sing. He said, no, wait a minute. I was trying to figure out what he wanted. I said, well, he said, no, you can't have him sing. Yeah. I said, well, what is it? Thank you.
Life eternal. Heaven rejoices. Jesus lives who once was dead. Join, O man, the deathless voices. Child of God, lift up thy head. Patriarchs from the distant ages, saints all longing for their heaven. Prophets, psalmists, seers, and sages all await the glory given. Life eternal, oh, what wonders! Crown on faith, what joy unknown! When amidst life's closing thunders, saints shall stand before the throne. Oh, to enter that bright portal, see that glowing firmament. Know with thee, O God immortal, Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent.
Oh, I want to thank Jesus for the Holy Ghost to tell me one of the greatest hymns I have heard. That's one of the great hymns of truth. And it all was so thrilling. I wish I could tell you, my voice brings us away down from where I was. It's away up here somewhere. In glory and joy and ecstasy, grandeur, wonder. Oh, what I sensed in the words of this. Oh, you read it so well. You played it so good. You were sight reading it. And I had to read the words with the music. See, because the words I never had heard before. For if I ever heard him, it was back 40 years ago when she and I'd go through that hymn book over 40 years ago. But you forget a few things in 40 years. And I can't remember that hymn. And to think that Jesus wanted those, I was going to say, now, Radiance, you come. No, he said, no. I said, what is it? And then I didn't realize there's two more stanzas. And these two stanzas were so great, I wouldn't have wanted to miss them. See, it tells about the kingdom of God and the prophets and the saints. Yes, sir. See, he's right here.
See, we were in the barn the other day, you and I and the children and my brother Terrence were in the barn. Yeah. And I was sitting in the buggy, and we were in the Holy Ghost like we are here, and we had a great meeting, didn't we? It was great, right there. Now, that's not the only one. There have been many meetings in the barn, hasn't there, Thomas? Amen. Yes, sir. And God has helped us. And the glory fell down on us in there, and I was privileged to commune with Joseph of old and Noah. Enoch and Joseph. I was privileged to commune in my heart, in the Holy Ghost, with Enoch of old who walked with God, and Joseph that did all God wanted him to do. I had fellowship in the Holy Ghost, and the power came down in a heart in that old barn, and the son was so thrilled, and the children, and my brother, as God, let me commune with Enoch, who walked with God, and was not, because God took him. Hallelujah. Had communion with Joseph in the Apostles' Creed, says we have the communion of saints of the ages or the present. Time, it's without time. The kingdom of heaven is without time or place. Amen. And here, once in a long while, Jesus will allow me the privilege. I'm so unworthy of this. Of the communion with the saints of God. In the Bible, in the Word, with the saints here. See, we're communing here this morning. See, we've had communion in our heart, one to the other. That's the communion of saints. But once in a while, he lets you just go into eternity and have communion with those prophets of old. Once in a while in prayer. Once in a while in preaching. Once in a while in exhortation. See, when I went in the barn that day, little did I know God was going to allow me to have fellowship with those saints of old.
You were in a hard place.
See, I'd been through battles and struggles. I had lots of heartaches and situations in various places. But I got in that barn and God came down and gave me the victory, the great joy.
Hallelujah.
Let me commune with the saints. And you were happy, weren't you, John? But every time I say it, it operates in his heart.
Thank you, Jesus.
See, God is to be praised. Oh, I want to thank you for these great songs. Thank you, Ms. Helm, for sitting up there for 3 hours. Over 3 hours she sat on this piano bench. She's 73 years of age. Now, a young person would be so tired. She got to feeling better all the time on the bench. She got to feeling better on the bench for 3 hours and some minutes. That ought to convince every skeptic in this place. That ought to convince every skeptic here.
Thank you.
73 years of age, afflicted for 48 years. Sometimes the Lord tells me that there's 4 things wrong with her and 6 things, different parts of the body for 48 years. And God would bring her up here and she got to feeling better.
Wonderful.
And here she went into the 4th hour. She passed 3 hours a while ago. And she felt she got to feeling better. Now listen, let me tell you something. That's something so wonderful that if we could get a vision of what God has done here this morning, even for my wife. Oh, for us, how God's blessed. You know, I look in a glass and I look so old. But when I get in the Spirit, I feel so young. Oh, my. Oh, I tell you. I'm here by the grace of God. The mercies of Jesus. Oh, we're thankful. Yes, we're thankful to Jesus for all your prayers and your fasting. Because in March, it looked like I couldn't make it much longer. And prostate gland trouble, and complications there, and the rectum. Also, certain things in my heart area that my wife, I couldn't tell her about. I needed help, and I needed it bad. And the liver, it looked like it was an awful steep climb. It was that steep. That's how steep it was. To ever make it from March to Maranatha, to Sky Depot, to make it to Utah, to make it to St. Louis, to make it to Louisville, to make it to the 22nd of August. That's how steep it was. But the mercies of God and people fasting for me over the United States, fasting and praying, spending hours and days for God to get in this body that's wore out. The throat, I didn't mention that. The body that's worn. You see, I've been one of the most wonderful religious persons that I had ever served as pastor. She was the president of the Women's Society of Christian Service, where there was hundreds of women. She was a school teacher, very talented. Marion Hunt. Some of the older people in the church would know her. She told me in 1939, she said, "You cannot live long, Reverend Hill. You cannot live very long.
No man can go the way you're going and live very long. And she was a woman of discretion, a woman of evaluation, a woman of intelligence, a woman of great knowledge, a woman of character, a woman of holiness, a woman of purity, a woman of vision, a woman of prayer, a woman of the Word of God. She said, you can't live very long. You're going too hard. You just have a little while to live. And that was 45 years ago. By God's grace, He spared me. And through your praying for me. See, I haven't been in this thing 99%. As far as I knew about it, I went in at 100%. I had to fight the devil nearly all the way. I had to fight demons of hell that's raged all around me, principalities and powers. And for years, I was almost by myself and my wife. Just maybe have a family away over here to get the vision to help me. Maybe one way over here to get the vision. Maybe 30 years ago, 40 years ago to help me. I said, Jesus has helped me. And now the precious ones praying for me here. I'm in debt to Jesus. We've had a great time together.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Radiance, you're ready to sing. Thank you. See, I would have had them sing a while ago and missed these last two great stanzas. If Jesus sees fit to ever tell me the hymn so beautiful again, we're going to be so deeply in debt. Well, I'm getting over my head in debt over and over and over and over and over of the revelations of God. Now, these boys are together because Jesus told me what to do. He led me. That's why these dear ones. Now, Timothy down in Florida can't be with them. That's the fourth member. But he was with them a few weeks ago. They came to my home and they sang just for all of us. And they're here because Jesus revealed what was to be done years ago. See, that's so great. See, if we could see the greatness of it, I don't know what we would do. We'd probably said, let's take out time and just circle the place. Well, if we knew how serious it was, we'd say, oh, my, we can't sit here any longer. We'll just have to take a walk or trot or run. To try to give Him the praise that's due Him.
Amen.
For thanksgiving.
Amen.
Because God led. This Wonderful. Didn't come by accident. Just like this meeting this morning. All these things. He didn't come because we thought it was due. No. Because we're just trusting. See, I feel so good. I feel so much better when I came in. You know, if you sleep a couple hours. I had 3 hours sleep the night before. And 3 or 4 hours the night before. And 2 or 3 hours the night before. And 2 or 3 hours the night before. And you know, of a night, you can't sleep very well. It's not easy, is it? We're thankful for helping Jesus,
Amen.
Helping us, Lord, Amen. Giving us strength. We want to praise Him for all He does for us. I want to thank Him. But I had to tell you that we're here because God led us to find these boys. You see, I've got to tell you that the man at the piano is a precious young man. He's a son of the farmers out in the state of Kansas.
Praise the Lord.
And Wendell Doss and his wife, are they here? Stand up wherever they are. They're, because of them, he's here. There they are. There they are. Is Barry here? Is Barry here? There he is. Now, these three right here. That's why we have this precious young man. Because they were willing to sacrifice for their son to go to Sterling, Kansas, because he got all the colleges. I said, well, I don't know where Jesus wants you to go. See, he's timid. He's backward. But, oh, he's a prince. He's a prince.
Yes, sir.
You look at his face, and you'll know if you can read anything.
Yes,
he loves Jesus. And his father and mother are dear. They are very, very precious in Jesus. And I said, now you just list all the colleges, possibilities. So I listed them down on a sheet. And I think you told me, of course, I couldn't remember because that was years ago. I think you told me it was the 16th one. 14th one. When I came down, got to the 14th one, and I said, what is Sterling College? Where is that? I never heard tell of Sterling College. They said, that's in the state of Kansas. And I said, well, that's where you're to go. That's 900 miles, I think, from their home, something like that. And that meant that you had to do without so he could go way out there. You had to sacrifice. It wasn't easy.
You had to do a lot of planning to get the finance to send him, and then you all had to have courage because you'd get homesick for each other. He went out there, and I said, "Now, Barry, you're going to find a precious person." Do you remember that? Do you remember it?
Yes, sir.
I said, "You're going to find a very precious person out at Sterling College in Kansas." Oh, that touches my heart, Don. I'm thankful, too. Oh, am I thankful? Oh, my. God had me to have him play a song in Israel. It was the old rugged cross, only it wasn't the one I ever heard. And I think it was one of the greatest. One of the greatest. Everyone believes that? Say amen.
Amen.
Now, that's the group that was with me in Israel that said that. Because Jesus helped him to get this and arrange it.
Yes.
It's his arrangement. And God marvelously blessed. And we praise him. It's because of these three here and their prayers and willingness to go where Jesus told me, a place I never knew existed. And God revealed to me they'd find a wonderful person. Right here he is, brother and sister Dawn. Barry, he's right over here. You found him in Sterling, Kansas, because God, the Holy Ghost, led.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Not, we didn't guess.
True.
We didn't say it'd be nice. But I said it's going to take a dying and a persevering and a pressing. And Jesus took care of you. And you found him. Thank you for obeying. You may be seated. You may be seated. And so we have Don because Jesus led.
Amen.
We have Jack because his father got a voice in the wilderness.
Praise the Lord.
And when he'd read it, he'd go in and he'd say, "Oh, Herod, here it is, here it is. Look here, look here. This is what I need."
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. Jack, stand up.
Glory.
Oh, first time he came in the church, I said, Roger was up there with me. I said, "Who is this fellow anyhow?" Roger says, "I'll get down and sit down. Let him come up and take my place." I never saw him before in my life. He had a light on his face. I tell you what happened was, when he came in, he was at home. And
Amen.
His face was shining.
Glory.
Shining like a light. I said, "Oh, Harriet, this is it. This is it. Look, read. Look here what this book says."
Glory.
He's just stirred up. He wanted to get wherever this service was. And he didn't get with us for how long?
January 77. January of 77.
Yes.
That was in the June revival, June 6th, I believe, of 76.
Amen. And I had to get all that time. And oh, what a meeting.
Yes, sir.
What a meeting. I didn't know who he was, but I said, "Oh, this man is hungry. This man is happy. This man is appreciative. This man loves God, loves Jesus.
Yes,
he's
sir.
Seeking to find a people that'll go with God too."
Yes, sir.
I saw it on his face when he came in.
Yes.
See if there's a light on you. It attracts me to you. The light of Jesus, the light of the Holy Ghost. When we came to the end of the meeting, I wanted him to dismiss the meeting.
That's right.
And when he stepped out in the aisle, he said to his three sons, and two of them are here, he said, "Come with me."
Amen.
What?
Yes.
When he stepped out in the aisle to dismiss the meeting, he said, "Three sons, come with me." That meant all three men, and they all three just stepped right out like this, came right down. Growing men, tall as I am or taller. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Walked right down the aisle, and he said to me, he said, "Would the Lord allow you to pray to dedicate our three sons?" The youngest was how old?
16.
16. The next one was?
18.
18.
And then the next one was? I was 19.
You were 19. So here all three of them were being dedicated at the altar,
thank you,
the
Jesus.
First time we ever met.
Hallelujah.
And gave them to praise God
the
and said, "Here they are.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord,
here
they are.
Jesus.
Give them back to you. Use them. Work in their lives. Live.
You,
lead
Jesus.
And
thank
guide
you,
them and bless them and help them to be like Jesus,
Jesus.
And go where Jesus
praise
leads
Lord.
Them.
Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord.
He got the voice in the wilderness, a voice in the wilderness because a man took those books
yes,
over
sir.
To Huntington.
Yes, sir.
West Virginia. And what was that man's name?
Monty Chittum.
Right over here. Stand up, Monty. Woo!
Glory. He took the book over. He found it, and we found them, and that's why he's here.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
Glory.
Yes.
Be to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
you,
Lord.
I'll tell you, it's one way.
Praise the Lord.
You say, Brother Helm, I wish you wouldn't get so loud. Well, I didn't know I was going to. I want to be quiet as I can, save my voice. But I get so excited. Yes. You may be seated.
Thank you, Lord.
We can't thank him enough.
It's so true.
When I took Timothy Joseph home from the hospital, he was how many days old? 3 days old. When I took him home from the hospital, that's my baby brother's son and his wife, Jackie. And as I come up over to the railroad, I turned to the back seat where my sister was, and I said, Jackie, Jesus' hand, God's hand, the Holy Ghost, is upon this baby. And here he is, the preacher of righteousness.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In October of 1967, I had 3 letters to mail. I was in Vienna, Washington, Virginia, just out of Washington, a few miles. And I said to him, I said, how would you like to go to the post office with me? He said, I'd be delighted. So he got in the car, and the glory fell upon me. I preached this hard. Oh, I preached under this joy and glory and victory to that boy, just he and me in that car, and he was converted. And there was such a light all over his face, and he met Jesus.
Amen.
And you were happy.
Oh, I was. I felt it. I felt the load just lift off.
Glory.
Thank you, Jesus, for saving him in our automobile.
Amen.
October 1967. He was 10 years old.
Hallelujah.
His father and mother, and his father would bring him to our home. And they'd sit him on the couch, and his feet looked about that far reaching the floor. Because the couch was high, and he was short. He wasn't very old. And I talked for about two and a half hours, sharing with my brother and with him how God had led me in those days and weeks. See, you boys that's been with me, have you heard this when you were young boys? Have you heard us like this, happy to tell about Jesus?
Yes, sir. Hundreds of times.
He sat there on that couch for about 3 hours. I never asked to get down, get a drink of water, go to the restroom. And when he got him home, you know what this son said to his mother? What was it you said? Can you remember?
He said it was about the happiest day of my life.
That's what he thought. He thought it was about the happiest time of his life. And he was a little boy. And he and Rebecca, too, I used to preach to him and talk to him about the kingdom of God. Stand up, honey. That's his sister. And I talked to him about this. We're supposed to review what God's been doing for
Amen.
Us. See, these aren't strangers. These are our dear ones
yes, sir.
That's been with us. And I would preach to these two right here for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours until Edward would say at 10:30, you better go to bed because I had to get up early in the morning for school. He had to do it, you see. He had to because he's a parent. And you see, we'd have such great times. You didn't want to go to bed, but you had to. Now, that wasn't one time or a half a dozen times. That was many times.
Many times.
Oh, yeah.
And you were so appreciative. You were so understanding. My own nephew and niece. And I was as happy to talk to both of you as if I was talking to thousands upon thousands. I was happy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now, son said it stirs his heart. Isn't that great?
It is.
So we want, before they sing, we want to tell you that it just didn't happen.
That's
it's
right.
Because Jesus led.
Amen.
God guided.
Thank you, Jesus. Mm-hmm.
See, things don't just happen. We need to give him the praise for it. Because Israel, the Bible says, Jeremiah 2:32 says, my people have forgotten me days without number. That's beyond trillions of days. He said, my people have forgotten me. That's the chosen seed. Had forgotten God days without any number. See, so easy we're going to forget too.
Yes.
And so God put this all together because of his presence.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise we want to thank him.
Yes.
Thank Amen.
You. Because you see, if I'm thankful enough, he could lead me today. See, if I'm thankful enough, he could reveal something to me any minute for his glory. See, I don't know what all he may do if I'm faithful and true in being thankful for what he's already done. See, if we're not thankful for what he's already done, how can we expect, honestly, anything else? You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you for standing. All right. Oh, wait just a minute. God said, wait a minute. What is it, Jesus? What is it? Is it a testimony? Rebecca, were you through talking? Or did you have something on your heart? Did you have a testimony? See, he told me, he said, no, they're not ready to sing yet. Yes.
I was thinking it was seemed like those times almost were like a fantasy or something, like a fairy tale. It would, and with the sweetness of Jesus was so wonderful. And I know Tim and I, when we'd go to bed, we'd say, oh, this made us hungry to want to someday walk with God.
Makes us hungry to want to walk with Jesus, with God. See, these children want to walk with God. They talk together about how they want to walk with God, too. Well, you see, if I'd let them sing, we'd have missed that, Rebecca. We wouldn't have missed that. That's like a kernel of wonder. Praise the Lord.
Even before we were saved, we longed for those times.
Even before they were converted, they'd long mm-hmm. for the times that we could share with them. Mm-hmm. And I'd be so happy, wouldn't I, with you? Oh, I'd be so happy. God, help me. Just as happy then as we are now.
Hallelujah.
Just as excited, just as delighted. Well, you see, when you walk with Jesus, we're just indebted to Him, aren't we? Oh, His presence is right here with us. Oh, Jesus, the risen, the one who rose from the dead. He's at the right hand of God interceding. He's soon to return for the bride who has washed herself white in the sacred blood. Praise God. How Jesus leads and directs. Oh, we can't praise Him enough for all that He's doing and what He will do. It will give Him the glory and the praise. I think it's wonderful. Rebecca graduated from one of the most spiritual schools in the earth. And she told her father when she came to graduation time, she said, I want you to know, Daddy and Mother, that if it hadn't been for the cessations of the waitings upon God, I could not have survived in victory. She said, I could not have survived Christian spiritual victory if it hadn't been for the waitings upon God cessations. And when she said that, what do you suppose Timothy said? He says, me too. Just think how serious it's been that these children, other children, that they would be helped so they would be strengthened so they can survive in victorious life in the Christian walk. I said, Edward, this is very serious. I didn't know this. I didn't realize it at all. She said, that's a fact. They both said, that's a fact. They said, we needed the sessions. We needed to be taught. We needed to be taught to lose our life, to give ourselves away, to be obedient, to keep the victory. We needed all the things that God gave us in the sessions of the waitings upon God. That's what they said. I didn't say it. I simply repeat what they said. Is that right, Edward?
Yes.
So, in debt. So we want to give Jesus the praise for that,
thank you,
too.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus, for doing all things. We want to give God the glory for everything.
Praise.
Now, you see, I was going to have the radio and say, he says, it's not time yet. I said, well, what is it? And I found it with this handmaid. If you heard what she said,
right.
you'd been just about ready to say thank you, too. When she came to Reverend Roundtree's when she was 16 years old, she was so burdened for the church before she ever got there. She was so excited. 3 weeks before they came, she could hardly wait to get started. That's right. And when she got there, she had more burdens. But she was so burdened for the church, and you were so thrilled with her burden. You and Blanche were so grateful that she was burdened, 16 years of age, for the church in St. Louis, where I've been now 14 times. Thank you for standing, honey. Thank you.
Watching the sun rise, feeling the warmth it brings, a host of singing birds reveal a new day. Breath of refreshing air, rustling of a gentle breeze, watching the the leaves wave from a tree, singing alleluia, 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 a new day. Walking the narrow path, stepping with surety, freedom that God has brought to pass. Watching a small child finding a little flower, smelling the fragrance that it brings, singing alleluia. Lace, sharing the loving grace of the Lord. Filled with unending joy, never having to be afraid, for Jesus brings peace for each new day. Singing alleluia.
See how the words of that all fit in the last hour? Did you notice how the words of this song fit, even to a child? What a wonder. Hallelujah. Sing the one about the eagle. This is Timothy Joseph's wife. This place is Karen, Helen, and Richard's daughter. We have Sally and Richard because of this daughter here. Is Sally and Richard, stand up. We have their ministry, which is invaluable to the church in the valley. And we have them because this daughter, at the age of 12 years, said, come over. Come over where we're having worship and feel the love that's there. Feel what's going on there. Feel Jesus leading there. And so Sally and Richard came over, and you hardly ever left us. You always stayed. Yeah, you just came and stayed. And their ministry, just think of the choirs and the music and all the wonderful things that God has helped these dear ones to teach the people at Scottypool. And one of the finest of pianists and a director and a trumpet player. And how God worked with them. We have them because this daughter believed that we walk with Jesus. Because the pastor walked with Jesus. We have them because of your faith, honey. That's why we have them. Right. See, it's a great story. Right. See, we don't want to forget to give God the glory for it. Because Helen Richards' daughter said, come over into Macedonia and help us. Where's Helen and Richard? Are they here? There they are. Stand up, gracious one. Richard and Helen Klein. Oh, just think. Just think. Your daughter was the missionary that brought these dear ones over into Macedonia. I'll tell you, it's nothing to forget. It's something to remember. We want to praise Him for it. Glory, glory. I'll tell you, it's something. Richard and Helen, when you came over where Oliver and I were, how did you feel?
We were so spiritually starved, Brother Hale. It was like a dream come true for us. We had been so starved and been in our church all of our lives. But when Karen said to us, after being in church all these years, she was 12, and she'd been taken into church, going through all the proper formalities of being taken into the church. Just a few weeks after that, she asked me what it meant to be saved. And it just shook me so much because she was 12 and very seldom missed Sunday school. We were youth group leaders. And it just hit me, this child, none of our children were being taught the gospel of Christ. And we began to cry out in our hearts for God to lead us to a people where we could speak about Jesus and our children would learn about Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
And it wasn't very long then that the Lord led us to Oliver Hoke.
Hallelujah.
So we're precious.
Oh, that's so great.
Man of God. And through his ministry, then we were led to your ministry. And there's just not words to express our appreciation.
We're indebted to Jesus deeply.
We're just so thankful. So very, very thankful.
Praise the Lord.
And we're thankful that not only Karen, we have Karen in the ministry, but
yes,
our two sons are with us. Our oldest is 23 and our youngest is 21. And our youngest has chosen to take leave from the Navy.
Are they here? Are they here? Oh, mm-hmm. Would they stand, please? Praise the Lord. Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. So grateful to have these sons here. Oh, it means so much. Thank you.
Just thankful, yeah. Brother Hill. That's all I can say. Thank you.
Yes. Glory. Glory to God. Richard, you want to say anything? Richard, you know, he helps me too. I'll tell you. One time I tried to get this one to help me and that one to help me and someone else to help me and this one to help me. They were all gone. I couldn't get anybody and I needed someone bad. I got a hold of Richard on the first floor and I was on the 10th floor and I'll tell you, he didn't have time for the elevator. He just ran up there and I tell you, he came up there so fast. I needed help. He came. I never have forgotten it. Amen. I won't forget that.
I'm just thankful that all this has come about because, only the Lord in heaven would knows where we would be if it hadn't have started as she's described it, you know. So we're just trying to hang on to Romans 8:28, where it says He works all things out.
Yes, you know. Sir.
It seemed like we were in bad places, but really we were in good places, and now we're thankful.
Yes, sir.
Because we're here today, and I'm thankful especially because all three of our children are here together.
Yes, sir.
When they get old like this, they don't come together, you know, so many times.
That's
Karen's in
many
Indiana.
Times.
Rich is in the Navy, and the three of us at home, but here they're all three together again.
Oh.
And you know, Brother Hemp,
yes,
as far as I know,
yes, Richard,
this is the only place they've ever been together like this in the kingdom. Things,
yes.
They were never together in any place except in church.
Yes.
Or where God was working.
Praise the Lord. Oh, that makes your hearts happy and rejoicing. I want to thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you for standing, dear ones. I couldn't miss that, you see. We have these dear ones because of this daughter saying, come and help us. Come over and enjoy the love that's here. I think it's so wonderful. I really do. I can't get over it. See, look what we'd have missed if she had. She just kept still. See, they needed Sally and Richard. That church needed them. They needed them just like a hungry man, a starving man that's famishing needed food. They needed them. Needed them. Needed their gifts. Needed their help and their understanding and their zeal and their knowledge. and their excitement in doing God's will and finding this great way of peace and joy. Yes, Sally?
Yeah. We needed them.
Exactly. Exactly, you did.
I was thinking through the night, I couldn't sleep for the excitement and the joy of being here. And I was thinking of that little chorus, "Oh, brother, aren't you glad you ever joined this army?" And I was thinking, "Oh, brother, I am glad I have joined this army."
Oh, brothers, aren't you glad you ever joined this army? Oh, brothers, aren't you glad the sea gave away? When Moses smote the water and the children, they all crossed over and they shouted, "Hallelujah!" And the sea gave away. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank thee, Jesus. Oh, it's so precious. Yes, I talked to Joanne Patrick, who's one of our precious sisters in our church at home. And she says, "Oh, Brother Helm, I'm so excited." She says, "I'm so excited. It's just as if I was going to attend my first waiting upon God." I thought that was real precious. That's what you were. Yes. I don't know how many people told me they were so excited. And I'll tell you, He's blessed us here today. And if He sees fit to bless us this afternoon like this, it'll be a wonder. Now, you see, we're here. In a few minutes, I've been here. Almost 4 hours. And Gregory McBride, he's 26 years old. If he's in a meeting for 2 to 3 hours, he's so exhausted when he goes home, he just has to sit in a chair. He can't hardly. And here I'm 42 years older. And it's true, isn't it, Gregory? Yes. And some of the young men tell me that when they get home after 2 or 3 hours, they can't hardly feed themselves. There's no strength. They don't have it. They're strong men. And here I am, almost 69, and God has helped me to have the strength. See, if you have a program, there's nothing to that. You can just, that's it. It's not hard. No, it doesn't take any strength to go through a program. Oh, you've got it right in front of you. But if you try to do what God says, oh, how it takes God's strength to help you. Does me. And we want to praise Him for it, what He's done. Thank you.
I stood and watched an eagle glide, spread his wings and soared across the sky. So gracefully he flew, rising effortlessly. I wanted to know just how to be free. Curled round mine, perfectly formed, newborn, the image of two. Infinite mystery, I wanted to know where life comes from. What human intellect can sway must be explained away. Earth, wisdom, religions of men.
That's what we're talking about.
Search without end to fill the spirit housed within. Simplicity of God somehow escapes man. Made your spirit. glide on the wind. Come, let's fly on the wind. Come on, let's fly on the wind. On the wind.
On the wind.
On the wind.
Oh, how beautiful. Thank you, dear ones. Oh, that was so sweet. See, we've talked about that this morning. The religions of men and all these good things we do, but without the leading, it all doesn't go on. It's just dead. There's no power in it. And when God leads, all the children are brought to the parents. See, if it was a pamphlet written, how all the children had been brought to the parents in this fellowship. It's a great story.
Yes.
How the hearts of the children are turned to the parents.
Yes.
And the parents to the children. If a pamphlet could be written on all the fellowships that's happened in all the states, it'd convince any skeptic or infidel. Because cults take the children from the parents. But this brings them together. The leading of the Holy Spirit, the kingdom of God brings them together. And the little ones, that big, they love it too. Yeah, they get right in it. My great-grandbaby sit in front of me the other night for 4 hours and watched me all the time. She's 5 years old. The next night, the meeting went into sixth hour, and at 1:15 in the morning, she came up to me in our suite, and she says, "Grandfather, I have something to tell you." I said, "Yes, honey, what is it?" "God help me." That's David's baby and Barbara Jane. At 1:15 in the morning and sit with me going to the sixth hour in the meeting, and didn't play with the books, and didn't open up any papers, didn't scribble anything, just watched me. But God's grace, could this ever be again? Now it's time for lunch. We're not ready. But we got to eat because they prepared it. We've already had a feast. We've been eating something that you can't put on a plate. We've been eating something you never can get on a stove. We're eating something that's better than most any little thing you can think about. As good as it is. This beats it a little bit. Maybe a bushel full or a rod or I don't know what, or a yard. So I know we must get ready to dismiss. You feel free to go down now, and thank you so very much. Everyone enjoyed it, say amen.
Amen!
It's like, no, did you hear the repercussion? Did you hear it? I just asked for an amen. I didn't prime the pump. It was right there. Let's be with God's grace, could be that good again. It rang through this plate. Well, I don't know what this room ever did. The walls, I don't know what they did. They stayed where they were, but I heard the coming back. Did you notice it? Amen. Going to take up an offering. Going to have an offering. How many of you have read the newsletters and got your envelopes with you? Lift your hands. We know how many read their newsletters. Of those that haven't been able to get the newsletters, they have an envelope for you. And all of you that don't have an envelope, just look around you. There'll be somebody, hold up your extra envelopes. There'll be, half a dozen. Just look. Now look at the envelopes. I want you to watch all these envelopes. I just did. Here they are. There's lots of them. Look, you've got lots. Look, all over this place. See, they brought all the envelopes so we'd have a supply. Now, in this envelope, see, we got so many envelopes here, they'll have to work to get it back in their pocket. And see, I just requested this in the newsletter. It just came out a few days ago. And this envelope, those of you that want to share with the needy this morning, if you've got $1 or $5 or $10 or $20 or $50 or $100, you can put that in the envelope and just fold it up, because that, our people here will not count. That's going to be for me to look after the needy and the poor. In Israel, I did this, and there was many that were helped. Bills paid. All the minister's children that were with us got money. Some of them didn't have any money. That is a marvelous story of love, how God worked. So all of you that want an envelope, just lift up your hands, and those of you who get started and get right to them all around. Those of you who want to help us with the needy. And then that goes down below. But if you want to help us in the meeting, our expenses here is a few thousand. If you want to help us, it's not in the envelope. It'll be separate. It'll just be in the plate separate. But this in the envelope is for the poor and the needy that we will know about. So we distribute it to the widows or to the needy, whoever they are, that the Lord reveals. And there's different ones that will take care of this. It won't be with me. It'll be with someone that's designated to help take care of it. So all the offering in the envelopes will not be counted by the people here. They will not be counted. But the offerings that you want to send in to Revival Fire Day for the expenses of this meeting, they will count that, and we will know what that is in a few hours, we trust. So let your heart be encouraged to do just as God would guide you. Praise the Lord. All right, we're going. Sally, would you come, please, to the piano? Oh, wait just a minute. I'm sorry. I was going to have her play. And the Lord said, wait a minute. Isn't that something I want Sally to play? I said, no. Well, all the pianists hold up your hand so I can see. I don't know where the one is that's supposed to play. I don't know where the one is. This young man right back here. Yeah, you're the one.
Michael Benjamin. Pigeon Pool.
What?
That's a bassoon.
Oh, really? What? Bless your heart. I wish you could hear him play the bassoon. Oh, it starts up. I didn't know him. I'm away from him. I can't see him. See, I wanted Sally. And here, I want to tell you, he really stirred us up. Come right on up. Praise the Lord. And have you got your bassoon with you? What's right there? Do you play the piano also? All right. Lord, you want the bassoon or the piano? It's the piano. Oh, I hope you get to hear how he plays. What?
Yes,
don't fold the money up. Don't fold your money up. Don't fold it up. Keep it full scale out. You see, it takes them so long to get them all, 100 bills. Keep it out like that in the envelope. And don't fold it up in the plate. Because it takes a long while for all those that count it to take care of it. I've forgotten how many minutes, how many hours it takes. And a big offering to look after this. Praise the Lord. It is wonderful. I didn't know who this dear one was. I said, I wanted my sister Sally to play. He said, no. I said, well, hold up your hands. And here I couldn't see him. I said, Jesus, who is this precious man? I can't tell who he is. See, I just saw him. Let's see, has it been 2 years this fall? See, I haven't seen him for 2 years. And I was with him in the mountains down south of Knoxville, Tennessee. And he would play the bassoon. Weren't you stirred up?
Oh.
My wife was so stirred up with him. You were?
We all were.
We all were. Everybody was there. He has a rare gift of God. And here Jesus tells me, isn't that great when I look at you at Operation My Heart, that God is telling me he used to do the playing. See, the Lord wants, he knows what he wants if we'll let him. But they wouldn't believe Jesus. And they didn't believe the prophets. But I hope you'll believe. And be appreciative. Be thankful. Lord, we're going to have you play. Father, we sanctify this offering. We ask it. No, wait just a minute. I'm not to pray. I thought I was. He said, wait a minute. My grandson, David, when I come to him, the operation is in my heart. Praise the Lord. Now, see, I was going to pray. He said, oh, no, you're not praying. I said, well, who's going to pray? So I started around. And when I get to him in that chair, the Holy Ghost operates right here.
Thank you, Jesus.
And Walter, it's in Walter's heart. Praise the Lord. Isn't that great? Amen. So you may pray. Thank you.
Blessed Jesus, we ask that you bless and sanctify this offering.
It's sanctified.
Oh, Jesus, we thank you for this word from heaven. Oh, God, we praise your holy name, Jesus. Pray that you would supply every need, Jesus, through these offerings. For the needy, Jesus, I pray that you would direct where it's to go. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
When he said sanctify, the Holy Ghost says, I sanctify it right there. His prayer was so sweet, wasn't it? Did you hear that mellow sweetness? Yeah. Praise the Lord. Been praying with him since he was born. All right, we'll have it now. Thank you.
Yes, dear ones. You may come down, all of you, if you want to, all of you, come right down to the front. Yes? All right. How many can you hand out? How many of these do you have?
Have
10 or 12. All right. We'll need some more men. Need some more men. How about you men stand up here and just give them one of these, please? Yeah. All right. That's right. Get right out in the community. Get right out in the congregation. And we'll just take up the offering just as they feel they want to. All right. We're here.
Thank you. number. Again like this. The Holy Ghost alone can tell us what to do. Oh, just think, he told me that Benjamin was to play and I didn't know who he was. I didn't know he was here. Oh, my. The joy of the Lord, the glory of God, the work of Jesus, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Oh, the presence, the power, the sweetness, the glory is almost as great as it was in Israel the night of the love feast. Right here. It's on the inside. It's almost as great, Thomas, that night. It's all so sweet, so precious in the heart of man and woman. Oh, we don't hardly want to move. We don't hardly want to move. His presence. Oh, his presence of love and light, righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Oh, Jesus, Heavenly Father, Holy Spirit, we worship Thee. This is fit to gather back with us this afternoon. I don't know what time you want us back here. Jesus, do you want us here at 12:30 or at 1? He tells me 1. That's where the operation is. Be back at 1, not 12:30. And we praise Him. Try in your heart to praise Him for how He's helped me here this morning, helped all of us, to help me know what to do. Because everything had to be in divine order. Everything, just the way Jesus wanted it. So we could all be helped, encouraged, His presence. See, this is like morning. This is like morning. You can feel it, can't you, James? Son, can you feel like morning up here?
Yes, sir.
You feel like morning up here? It's morning. It's morning. It's sunrise. It's sunrise up here. I hope it is down there. It's sunrise up here. See, when God told me 63 years ago I belonged to Him, He would use me in His kingdom. The grandeur of that moment was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't tell you how much greater than this. But we want to give Jesus all the praise and all the glory for His love here this morning, His holy presence. Remember that when we're dismissed, you don't just all go out. When I leave, please stay put. Don't start going unless you're with us and have been asked to go with us. Or you've gone with us before and the waiting's upon God to stay until the ushers tell you how to leave here. When we go quietly. We don't start talking loud. We whisper. Be sure that the hymn books are up on the chair after a while when we dismiss. And as you go, go as the ushers guide us. And if you can get through the meal, go right away to your room and lay down. While you lie down, pray. You'll go to sleep, maybe. And then be back for the session just a few minutes early. We just have 2 hours. That isn't long. For me to be able to recover, to get back here, will be a wonder. Because the men that are in service this long, it takes a while to ever get recovered. Sometimes it takes 1 or 2 days to recover from this, from what it takes out of you. If you want your tickets, some of you that do not have your tickets as yet for meals, Brother John will tell you what to do. Vera will take care of the announcement, and she will now tell you how to proceed. This precious daughter, we're so glad for you and Kenneth being with us to help us.
any meal tickets that you haven't picked up before a meal, or if you haven't canceled them, we won't be able to give you a refund because we have to pay for the number that we tell them. So if you could pick your tickets up, as those of you that have ordered especially, please try to get them soon so that we don't just keep holding them for you.
Please hear that. Please get
that. We'll be out
that.
There immediately as you leave the room.
You want also, them to go to a certain desk to pick up our tickets?
Yes, we'll have a ticket table, I believe, outside here.
Good, good.
Also, the Hilton counts the plates. So would you please be very careful to use one plate per ticket because we'll pay for the plates as a meal. So if you will be careful, please, to use one plate per
ticket.
One
plate.
Also, please have your tickets ready. When you go in to get your food, there will be ticket takers. Please do not ask them to let you go ahead and have your food. You forgot your tickets.
Please do
it's
not do it.
It's such a very, it's hard to try to keep that straight. So if you've lost your ticket, talk to me. But if you've forgotten it, please go get it and then give it to the ticket taker. Also, children under 5, there is no charge. You will have to tell the ticket takers that you have a child under 5 so that plate, I will have a record of that plate. She will put a different kind of a ticket in for us to count. Thank you. Please pick your tickets up.
All right, thank you. Any other announcements? Secretary, please. Thank you.
I thank the Lord for the work of the Holy Spirit and the privilege to be in this place with you and to be on this platform and feel God's presence in the company of angels. It is a wonderful thing, and thankful that God can even sanctify announcements. As you, Reverend Helm said, go quietly, please. Every place we go, may we go quietly. If you haven't investigated how to shut your door effectively, if you don't use a key, there is no quiet way to do it. From the inside, if you're going into your room, go inside the door and turn the knob, and then you can pull the door to quietly. You don't have to bang it. Going out, put the key in the door and turn the key, and then you can pull it quietly and turn the key back. Otherwise, they just bang. You probably found that out.
Yeah, we hear that.
And that bothers people. They can hear that jolt. Well,
it's disturbing.
Be very quiet in the hallways, in our rooms. The hotel is providing soft drinks at the meals, particularly the evening meal. I'm not sure about this one. I know the evening meal for 50 cents. Tea, coffee, and milk are included with the meal. As many of you have already found out, for breakfast, those of you who can just operate on a donut or a Danish, orange juice and coffee, those are all 50-cent items on an honor system out here in the hallway. The restaurant is open at 6 o'clock in the morning, and it will be open until 8 at night, which means that those of you who are not eating the meals here may go to the restaurant if you wish to eat. Parking tickets, those of you in the inn and those of you outside this facility who are coming in here to park, go to the reservation desk and they will stamp your ticket, and the cost per day will be $2 rather than $3.75. They are making a concession that they hardly ever make because it is an independently operated business. But they are helping us, and we want to be thankful for that.
Oh, yes.
And thank them for that, and make sure you have your ticket stamped. If you're going in and out during a day, those of you who are staying in another facility might be going in and out and ask for a pass, and they have some kind of a pass to give you to indicate that you're going to be going in and out. Allow the staff, there are those with Reverend Helm, his entourage, and then there are those who are involved in especially prepared meals.
Yes.
That are working with Martha. And if you would allow them to leave upon dismissal, and everyone, if you then, as Reverend Helm has asked us, if we'll hold steady, the ushers will show us out in a uniform fashion, and we would ask you when you leave, they go through the doors, don't linger in the hallways, either to line up for a meal or to talk. If you would, please completely clear the hallway area and just move right on. If you're going to the line, let the line form outside the hallway, please, and allow others to go out. Otherwise, we'll be in great congestion. Please do not leave your children unattended any place.
Right.
May your children remain with you at all times.
Please.
We will be very thankful. The Evangel Voice book desk will be open at 10:30 and 4:30, those approximate times, meal times, both days, and it is out here in the corner of the large area. We want to thank all those who helped set up, make all the arrangements. Many have helped, couldn't name them all. I would particularly thank Robert Allen for this lovely manifestation of his gifts. It's very lovely, and we thank him and all those who have helped. White Harvest, Christ Fellowship for the piano and for their sign, for Muskegon, West Shore Christ Fellowship for sound equipment, and those who are helping us, Laddie Helzer for this lovely carpeting. And that doesn't cover everyone, I know, but we want to particularly thank them and all those who helped. That's probably adequate for the moment. Thank you for your time and your attention and your desire to obey God.
Praise the Lord. Oh, you did well. Thank you for that information. Thanks to our sound men. Thanks for all those that assisted. And for all of you that are ushering. And all the flowers. And the flowers have been sent to us. And fruit. And all the nice things. We want to give praise to Jesus. I can't get over the beauty of this place. Robert Allen is to be commended. And if you want to tell him thank you, it would be nice to get an envelope and tell him inside for something to make him feel good and take care of some obligations. There's a lot of envelopes here. All you have to do is just ask for an envelope. How many envelopes do we have? And if you want to put in something like that, a dollar or two, it will help him a lot. He didn't know this was coming, but you see, if we get a decorator to do all this, I don't know where you'd find one for under many, many hundreds.
Brought his own light man.
Brought his own
light column underneath.
He brought his own light man, you say?
Yes,
his own light man, and all these things are set up back here. It's not just a simple thing. He's got going here. And so if you can help me like that, I would be thankful. And the carpet is from Laddie and Sue Helster. They're real precious to us. And I'd like for you to write them and tell them how you appreciate this. And if you want the address, please see some of our staff or our ushers, and they'll give it to you. They're up about Warsaw, Indiana. Are they here? They weren't able to come. Any other announcement that should be said that I do not remember? Any word? Then we come back just a few minutes before 1. And how are we coming? Rejoicing? Rejoicing? Believing? Cautiously? Quietly? With thanksgiving? Praying to God? To have faith? Being sure that we praised Him enough already for what He's done this morning. His presence, that it won't leak out of our life. It won't be gone because Satan will come and take it away from you if you're not fortified. May you be encouraged. Be strengthened in the name of Jesus. Those of you who are suffering, behold, be healed. Be well, be delivered. Let the suffering leave your body. I ask you to leave the head on the stomach and the body. I ask it to leave the joints in the name of Jesus. Take it in the name of Jesus and for the glory of God. Be thou healed and quickened and strengthened and refreshed and sustained round about the everlasting arms. Jesus said, as you go, heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out devils, freely you receive, freely give. Be encouraged in Jesus. Let us stand, please. When I leave, just There'll be a company going with me because they have several things to look after behind the scenes and for many of us. So I trust that you will hold steady and God will strengthen you for that and will honor you for it. We will now have the closing prayer and we praise the Lord for that. Scott, would you come, please? Glenda, would you come, honey? Praise the Lord. Everybody have enjoyed this morning. Would you like to say, praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord!
Thank you, Father.
Precious Jesus, we just want to thank you and praise you for your presence here with us this morning. Dear Lord, we don't know of any greater thing we could have had, Jesus, than for you to be with us here in this place, Lord, and to bless us so wonderfully, to grant us the privilege of being here with your servant, O God, who has walked with you through the years and obeyed you through the years, and who without his revelation through him, Lord, we wouldn't be here. So, Jesus, we just thank you and we praise you for touching our hearts and encouraging our souls and challenging us, Jesus. I just pray that you'd help us to grasp a hold of it, Lord, like it's our life, Jesus, because it is. Lord, help us to grab a hold of it and live it, Jesus, as we should. Lord, we pray. Pray that you give strength and rest, Lord, as they go. Touch Brother Helm and Sister Helm's body, Jesus. Lift them up, Lord, in high places, Lord, so they might not feel the weariness of their bodies, Lord. Grant them strength in their legs and in their bodies, Jesus. Touch their limbs, Jesus, and their heads. Jesus, give them rest and strength, we pray. In your name.
Heavenly Father, we come before thee with praise and thanksgiving on our hearts. Oh, this is so great that we cannot even hardly grasp what we have been in. Oh, Jesus, this is a man of God, sent from God to give us the words that we need in these last hours before your coming. Lord, we want to think we're ready, Lord, but we aren't. But we praise thee, Father, for this instruction. And we pray that you'd get in our hearts. Lord, open our hearts, oh God. Help us to receive. Help us to receive the message and the instruction that you have for each one of us. Help us not to think, hey, that's for somebody else or that's for my neighbor. Lord, help us to look at ourselves and get it in our hearts, oh God. We pray that you'd fortify this within our hearts. Help us to realize, oh God, that you have sent a servant. You have sent a servant to do thy will. A voice crying, crying out of his heart. Crying out of his heart to get the people to obey, to hear and to obey. Oh, dear God, help us. Dear God, help us to obey. He's crying out of love. He's crying because he cares. Oh God, he's crying because he knows the seriousness. The seriousness of being faithful. Oh God, to one thing, to one leading, to one person. God, help us to get a little vision, a little insight into how important it is for us to be faithful to one person. Even if it's in the prayer closet where nobody sees us, or if it's just doing something little to encourage them, like smiling, or whatever, Lord, help us, oh God, to be faithful, to be true. Oh, dear Jesus, we praise thee. We thank thee for this. We praise you for what you've done. It's so great. Oh, God, it's so great. Help us, oh, Lord. Bring it back to us, Jesus. Help us to feast upon it. Lord, Mary pondered these things in her heart. Help us, oh, God, to continue to ponder these things and not just lose them and be ready for the next blessing or for what you're going to do next, oh, Jesus. We pray that you'd help us to savor. Help us to savor the things of the kingdom. Oh, Jesus, help us not to be earthly minded. Help us not to be worldly minded, oh, God. It's so serious, and we don't even know. Oh, God, help us not to be earthly minded and worldly minded, but Jesus, help us to get our minds and our hearts totally upon thee to do thy will. We command each one. We pray you'd lift every single burden, each one individually. You care whoever it is, Lord. You care about each one, each care, each concern, Lord. You love, you care. So we pray that your healing virtue would flow out of the hem of your garment. And that you'd take care of situations, that you'd do the impossible, that you'd part the waters of the Red Sea, that you'd do that which needs to be done, O God. Answer the prayers, O God, of the people. Let thy will be done. And Jesus, help us to walk in spirit and in truth. O Lord, help us to be sensitive, be tender-hearted people, to be a gentle people, to be a holy people, to be a righteous people, to be a compassionate people, to be people with pure hearts, with the pure, true love of Jesus, and not just the love that we try and make up, oh God, because we don't have enough love. Well, this is a time when I need that love. Jesus, help us to be reminded of what your servant has said, and help us to die to self, Lord, even though we may not fully know what that means. Help us to die to self and obey thee. And I pray that your true love would come out and would heal the people around us, oh God, who need you. Oh Lord, help us to be true, to be faithful, to be obedient. Jesus, help us to rise up and be the people of God. Oh Lord, to be the true church of God. We just commend everything into your care. In Jesus' precious name we pray and ask it. Amen.